Good afternoon, Penn High School, and welcome to this 19th and Friday edition of PNN. I'm Maxwell Bernstein.
And I'm Sieanna McClellan. Let's hop right into your news and announcements for today, October 16th. But first, let's blast off to the stars with a package on the DVT brought to you by PNN reporters China Mylan and Lindsey Zimmerman. Stay tuned.
Digital video theater. And a digital video theater is a 30-foot dome that we have here that allows students to be fully immersed in the learning experience.
The planetarium has a long history of educating students in the community about our universe and the world around us. In 2011, the once-known planetarium was changed to be known as the DVT. Each year, the DVT uses a lot of computer power to run the shows that are filmed with many GoPros and other cameras.
We try to have a new show every year. This year, we've been blessed. We've received a grant that's allowed us to have 4 new shows, which is really cool. So we have a show about cells, one about the sun, one about the dynamic Earth, and we have D-Day about Normandy, a historical aspect.
There are a variety of shows that are available for all ages. The new website offers teachers to schedule a show for their classes as well as purchase tickets.
We have a historical show, D-Day. So we have a huge variety of shows, as well as what you would expect, the traditional shows, and we can do live presentations to show you the celestial sky.
Besides providing shows for students, the DVT offers public shows for the community. The shows will run from September 10th to May 25th, 2016. To view the schedule, you can visit the DVT website at dvt.phmschools.org/public-show-schedule.
Reporting for PNN and Lindsey Zimmerman, I'm China Mylan.
Thanks, China and Lindsey, for that out of this world package.
Basketball cheer tryouts will be taking place on October 27th and 28th from 3:45 to 7 o'clock in the East Balcony. If you are interested, you must sign up in the athletic office by next Friday, the 23rd.
The Miss South Bend and Miss Great Lakes pageant is looking for more teen girls to compete on Sunday, October 18th. If you have any questions, email Emma Tarkington at etarkington28@phm.k12.in.us.
Hey, Penn High School, I'm Tyron Clifton here with your sports updates. Women's soccer won their regional match against Culver Academy 7-0. Sydney Bright, Christina Lynch, Molly McLaughlin, Courtney Siegel, Hannah Earhart, and Melanie Cross scored goals in an exciting win. The women next play St. Joseph Saturday at 2 in Goshen for the regional crown. Come out and support your Kingsman football team as they take on the Cavemen at Mishawaka in the annual Backyard Brawl, scheduled to start at 7. The volleyball team plays tomorrow at Penn in the Tom Heck Varsity Tournament at 9 in the morning. Well, that looks like all the sports we have for you today, Penn. I'm Tyler, and now back to the desk.
Penn High School's Spell Bowl team hit the road to Oxford, Indiana Monday night, October 12th, to win the Benton Central Invitational with a near-perfect score of 89 out of a possible 90. The win was the fourth invitation title for the Kingsmen this season in as many outings. For a full list of names and placing, please visit our website and search Spell Bowl. And now we'll head to a check of your weather for this weekend with Joe.
Greetings, Penn High School, and have I got some great news for you. It's almost the weekend. I'm PNN weatherman Joe Bersey, and I thought it would be nice to talk about today being World Food Day across the globe, what with the annual student hunger drive going on right now. Please consider how lucky you are to have such a stable food supply, and please consider those around the world, around the state, and around Michigan who do not, and donate generously to the student hunger drive. So now, let's head into the weather for today, October 16th. We will be quite chilly today, having only a high of 52. We will also be mostly cloudy today, so expect a cold and gloomy day. And the start of the weekend doesn't look much better. Tomorrow, we will be even more cloudy and only expect a high of 48, so I would say under a blanket if I were you. Fortunately for us, the cold weather doesn't last the week. We warm back up to the 60s by the beginning of next week, and the sun starts to poke out from behind those clouds there. However, watch out for Thursday, as there's not only a chance of cooling down, but also having some rain that day as well. That looks like your weather for the week ahead. Now let's head back to the desk.
Thanks, Joe. Well, that wraps up our show for you today, Penn. I'm Sieanna McClellan.
And I'm Axel Bernstein. Don't forget to follow us on Twitter at Penn News Network and visit our website, pnn.phmschools.org.
There are only 6 days until fall break and 15 days until Halloween. So get ready to relax, have some candy, stay warm out there, Penn, and have a great weekend.